This past summer, I was fortunate enough to be chosen by the Massachusetts House to go down to Virginia and to represent Massachusetts in a meeting of legislators, one legislator from every state, in order to discuss what was happening in state legislatures across the country. That was held at the University of Virginia. And I was happy to hear the last debate that Janet and I share a common political inspiration, which is Thomas Jefferson. And as I walked the grounds of the University of Virginia, I went up to the rotunda, and I had a special moment where I was allowed to look through the window that Jefferson last looked through, just hours before his death. And when you look through that window, what you see is the pavilion of the University of Virginia. And I can only imagine that Jefferson must have been so proud, because what he did at the end of his lifetime is he advocated for the public establishment, which also means the public financing of a state university. And Jefferson came forward and he said that there are some things in life, in government, however you want to look at it, that is so important that you can't depend on the private sector to do it. You can't depend on individuals to do it unorganized. That you actually have to institute the public as a whole through public government and through finance in order to achieve it. And I felt as I looked at that pavilion that what was so important to him is that he knew he was giving individuals the opportunity to be something greater than what they were. He was giving them the opportunity to be the most of what they could be. And interestingly, he served as governor, in addition to president, but he served as governor of the Commonwealth of Virginia. And I always thought it was special that Massachusetts was called the Commonwealth also. Not the state, but the Commonwealth. Why? Because there's an idea that with shared resources, we can take care of our seniors and provide them with prescription drugs so they don't have to choose between food and prescriptions. So that we can say to a young person like me growing up in Gloucester, you have the opportunity to go to college and to be all that you can be. So I just appreciate that opportunity. I appreciate the opportunity to be here tonight. And I thank you and the Gloucester Daily Times for having this debate.